What's going on? Jason Phillips here, owner and founder of the Nutritional Coaching Institute. And today we are answering the question, how do I know when it's time to stop my diet? Now, before I give you that answer, do me a favor, look below this video, give us that thumbs up, make sure you're subscribed. And of course, click that link in the description so you can get your copy of the Nutrition Coach's Cheat Sheet completely for free. All of the information I've been using the last 16 years with my personal clients. And of course, the information I've shared with thousands of other coaches to help them grow and scale their impact and their income. Now, obviously, like I said, I've been working with people for 16 plus years, and I understand that diets can be short, they can be long, but ultimately at the end of the day, we want them to become a lifestyle. And so the real answer to how do you know when it's time to stop dieting is not really sure I ever want you to view your eating habits as a diet, so I don't love the whole notion of starting and stopping. Instead, let me help you understand how I approach a year-long dietary pursuit and how that can ultimately extend into how you live your life, how you continue to achieve your goals, and get rid of this whole stopping and starting notion. And we do what I call nutritional periodization. And I think these, you know, I'm probably known for implementing two very big things in the space, one being the triangle of awareness, two being this periodization model. And, you know, when I started thinking about it, I was working with a lot of professional athletes. I think at the time I was working with a lot of pro golfers. We started asking ourselves, what do they do throughout the year? And how do I match up their nutritional intake with the demands that they're currently experiencing? And I realized there was four very distinct phases. They were going through a season, golfers a very long season. They were then going into a postseason, an offseason, a preseason. Then I started doing this with NFL guys, NHL guys, NBA guys, and it was all the same, right? They all had a season where the whole goal is to win. Right? That's all that matters. When pro athletes are in season, they're not worried about their six pack. They're not worried about their biomarkers. They're worried about winning. That's what they get paid to do. But then postseason, we are worried about those things, right? We're worried about how we feel. We're worried about the nicks and the damage on the body. We're worried about making sure our hormones are intact, our gut health is intact. All the things that were likely damaged during the season, we're going to fix. And then obviously every athlete needs to improve. The level of competition in every sport is going to get bigger and bigger. And so we have to get better and better every single year. And then of course the preseason where you're transitioning out of this strength and skill acquisition and you're moving into more of an energy system type setting or more of a sport specific type setting. I realized that this is how I was programming my athletes, and I asked myself, can I apply that to regular people that are trying to lose fat or lose fat, keep it off, and ultimately lose fat and then perform better and ultimately have multiple sets of goals? And I realized that actually this has application in every single thing that we do. All right, so if we look at the traditional diet as it is, and the question that brought us to this video today is how do you know when to stop a diet? More properly stated is going to be, how do you know when the active pursuit of your goals is over, right? And we would categorize this as a season. So the truth is when you get to your goal, okay? If you've gotten to your goal, obviously now we can shut this down, and there's gonna be multiple phases, and I'll touch on that in just a second. Now, some people will not ultimately be able to achieve what they set out to. They may have dietary history, they may have hormonal imbalances that are coming into play, but that is for another video. For most people, when you get to the end of your goal, that is not the end of your diet, but that's when you shut down phase number one of this periodized model, which is the active pursuit of your goals. Now, we know that every dietary endeavor comes with it a host of adaptations, comes with it a host of things that are not normal and not necessarily good for us long-term. We know that just by decreasing calories, it's a navigation away from set point. We know the body is going to slow down the metabolic rate. We know that potentially there's some HPA axis issues if it was a long diet that need to be addressed. And we're gonna do this in the recovery phase or the postseason phase. When we ask the question, how do we know when the diet is over? Once again, properly stated, how do we know when this phase is over? Well, the phase of recovery or the phase of postseason is over when you have returned to homeostatic balance. When you have recreated maintenance, when all things are normal, so when biofeedback is normal, when hunger levels are normal, when mood, energy, focus, sex drive, all of the things are normal in your life and you have recreated caloric maintenance. That's when that one can end. Then we're gonna wanna go into an improvement season. So just like athletes that need to gain strength and skills, we need to gain dietary skills, okay? We need to have better relationships with food. We need to understand, how do I stay lean while still having ladies' night or guys' Saturday or whatever it might be? How do I still do that while having a few beers on the golf course once a week or having my date night or my cheat night? You know, anybody that knows me knows I wanna eat pizza every single place we go. Shout out to the other videos of the pizza reviews coming soon. Rico, we gotta do that. At the end of the day, we all have to improve our dietary habits. For some people, maybe it's not the relationship with food, Maybe it's improving metabolic capacity. Maybe it's just, you know, wouldn't it be nice, Mrs. Jones, if you're eating 1400 calories to be ripped right now, but in the future you could eat 2400 calories to be ripped. All of a sudden on ladies' night, you're eating 1,000 calories more, you're able to enjoy more treats, and you're able to still look and feel the way that you want to. This is going to come from improvement season. Now, that phase will end really in relation to what your next goal is, okay? So this isn't gonna be when you achieve the goal, but we do necessarily have to have this phase, all right? And then finally, we're gonna want to go into a preparation phase. I believe that the most overly looked component of every diet is the lack of preparation. I think that every diet comes with a set of rigors that are not part of normal life, meaning we didn't wake up and get put on this earth and understand that we should be tracking our food intake every day, weighing, measuring, putting it into MyFitnessPal, whatever it is. That's a skill that has to be, number one, learned, but then number two, implemented. It has to be understood and prepared for, okay? We also understand that when you go into a calorie deficit, especially longer you're in a calorie deficit, it doesn't feel great, okay? You're gonna have a little bit less energy. You're gonna have less of an affinity to go work out, to have that need. And we need to be prepared for that. And so a really good coach is going to spend a week or two getting you used to tracking again, getting you used to weighing and measuring, not creating expectations on these things, but just simply getting you acclimated to the tasks that will ultimately allow you to be successful. And this is what we would call the preparation phase. This is usually gonna be relatively short in duration, probably 2-3 weeks in the general population world. Obviously, athletics is a slightly different thing. But when you start to put this all together, you start to see that this never really ends. You're always maintaining a lifestyle, and this is how we're all the nutrition coaches in the world say it's not a diet, it's a lifestyle. These are the components of your lifestyle. You're always either actively pursuing your goals, recovering from that active pursuit, improving your skills to be able to do it better next time, or preparing for what is to come. And this is where diets never truly have to start and stop. This is where you can allow it to truly become what propels you to be your best 24/7, 365 days a year, and for the rest of your life to come. And ultimately, this is how all of the clients that have come through NCI, through our program, are continuing to do one thing, and that's choose impact over everything.